Does tesamorelin make you tired? Well, I'm going to answer that question in this video, and we're going to deconstruct how it might be influencing some of the tiredness, but I'm going to encourage you to look deeper. And so by the end of this video, you'll have the confidence of knowing exactly what tesamorelin does from a clinical perspective and the flags that you want to look out for in case you are getting tired. So what is tesamorelin? Tesamorelin is a growth hormone releasing peptide. It is FDA approved to treat what's called lipodystrophy, or the accumulation of abdominal fat and visceral fat. It's a phenomenal peptide because what growth hormone does when you have adequate volumes of it is it allows you to sleep deeper, you recover better, protects your joints, protects your hair. And one of the most important things it does is it protects your immune system. So you have this beautiful gland called the thymus gland, and the thymus gland involutes as we age down to about the size of a pea. Starts out where it's really big when we're born, and then that beautiful gland just gets smaller and smaller, and that is the training ground for your T cells. Now, the T cells are responsible for executing on all the important missions from an immune perspective. So one reason why you may be tired when you're taking like tesamorelin or ipamorelin or any of these growth hormone releasing peptides is because there's some immune activation. And so based on what your blood labs show, you may be clearing out some pathogens that you didn't want to give free rent to anymore. So tesamorelin, that can be one indication. But generally speaking, there's been nothing I've seen in the literature that says a common side effect is fatigue. But here's the second thing that you want to be aware of. Tesamorelin does increase IGF-1, so you do become more insulin sensitive. That means you can utilize insulin better, but in a certain subset of the population, especially if your somatostatin and cortisol levels aren't balanced, you may have some insulin resistance that shows up, especially if you're not using cyclic doses or cyclic doses where you take a, 5 days on, 2 days off. And so that would be the other reason why you may be getting tired. And so you really want to make sure that you're testing your blood sugar before. And I would recommend getting what's called a CGM, or a continuous glucose monitor. And then you can see if there's things that are spiking your blood sugar or not. You can see how well your body is tolerating the tesamorelin. It's just the best thing if you're ever tired. That's like the check engine light that goes off in your car. It's like, do you want to just keep driving and keep your fingers crossed that you're going to make it to Alabama or wherever you're going? It's like, no, you want to make sure that the car is stable and the engine's going to get you where you want to go. Same thing with tiredness. So the third reason why you may be tired with tesamorelin is if you are in a building phase of muscle and you're losing fat, then something pretty dramatic is going on, because fat is like the structural tissue. It's not just like it melts off like we all wish it would, but it requires an enormous amount of metabolic energy when your body's going through these composition changes. And that requires really good sleep, really good recovery. And so if that's you, if you are in that state of muscle building, grab a foam roller. Foam rollers are phenomenal. I know they hurt, like when you put it on your IT band and your quads and your hip flexors, it's like, ah, but that fascial tissue is very elastic. The fascial tissue is what holds our muscles together. And so just by rolling them out, the foam roller, because you're increasing what's called hypertrophy when you're in the gym, because we want you lifting weights. Hopefully you're on our app where we're tracking everything that you're doing and giving you guidance there. But foam roller, 2 to 3 minutes every day, makes an enormous difference in your body's overall health and your muscle health, so that you can actually recover quicker and you won't be tired. The fourth thing that may make you more tired is if you've had disrupted sleep cycles and now suddenly you get this dump of growth hormone into your body, and now you're sleeping deeper and you are in this massive sleep deficit. And you're like, how can I be tired? I've been sleeping great. I never slept like this and now I'm sleeping great. Why am I more tired? Well, it's almost like your brain is starved out for that recovery phase. You need more REM, more deep sleep. So make sure you're looking at your Oura Ring or whatever you use. Maybe it's a Garmin. I like the Garmin watch, Apple watch. But track your sleep cycles so that you can see if sometimes, and it usually only lasts 3 to 7 days, But sometimes it's because now your body's sleeping deeper and it's recovery. So think of growth hormone as this beautiful signal, like, you know how you get the blossoms in the spring and like the cherry blossoms, you know, very famous in, you know, DC and then Japan, and I'm sure there's other areas of the world. But think of growth hormone when it's activated. What it's going to do is it's going to give you this beautiful ability for renewal. And you literally feel younger on it. Your body moves better. You have more adaptivity. You have less stress resistance, meaning you can tolerate the chaos in life a little better. But when your body's making a change, it's very demanding metabolically. And then the final thing that you want to be really concerned about with tiredness, if you are noticing it from Tesamorelin, is you want to look at all the numbers downstream. You want to stop it immediately if the tiredness is extreme. Reach out to your doctor, whoever prescribed it. If you are getting Tesamorelin from a research facility, I would absolutely just be very cautious of that. Make sure it comes from a licensed compounding pharmacy, a 503A, 503B. That is what we found can be the most important thing, is the quality of the peptide. The quality will improve the expression, and there should be no reason why you're tired. You can also make sure that you're looking at all the supplements you're taking. If your blood sugar is dropping too low, too high, sometimes you want to remove, like berberine, for example. It may be bringing your blood sugar too low. Or if you're on a GLP-1, like let's say you're on semaglutide or tirzepatide, those GLP-1s, you may not be eating enough food. And so that's the nice thing about Tesamorelin, is you can add Tesamorelin in when you're taking some of these GLP-1s. So generally speaking, run the tiredness through a filter. And the filter is, okay, what do you want the best version of yourself to look like? And then just go down the list. Am I getting good enough sleep? Am I following the 3-2-1 method? 3 hours before you go to bed, stop eating. 2 hours before you go to sleep, stop eating food. And then an hour before you go to bed, make sure that you have peaceful time. Am I eating the right nutrients? If you're eating too much sugar, too many carbohydrates, that's going to cause a massive blood sugar fluctuation. That can make you tired. Is your exercise appropriate? Are you actually putting in the right, what's called neuromuscular adaptation? Are you applying yourself in the gym? Or are you just going to the gym doing the same things you've done for years? Because a lot of people, they tell me they work out, but their workout's been the same thing for years, sometimes decades. And it's like your body will adapt very quickly. If you are now in this adaptive stage, which we hope you will be when you're on Tesamorelin, now you'll be building muscle. So just make sure that you've got enough recovery time. Look at your heart rate variability. And then as you're going through that lens, you also want to make sure there's no pain in your body, because pain can be one of the most limiting factors. And not only does it hurt the brain, but pain will also keep you from sleeping better and recovering. And Tesamorelin, if you do have pain, is really nice to stack with like BPC-157, TB4, and there's another amazing peptide called ARA-290. Now this is an EPO peptide, or a erythropoietin agonist. And what it does is you get better oxygenation, you have better nerve fiber signaling. So it's been studied clinically for like neuropathy. But using ARA-290, BPC-157, Tesamorelin, if you have pain, that can also help mitigate the tiredness. So the very first place we want to start, get your blood labs read, look at your liver, your hormones, your cardiovascular system, and then make sure you grab a free copy of my digital book. You can click on the link below. We provide it for you as a gift for being part of our growing community here at Ageless Future. I'm Regan Archibald. It's an honor to have you here. I'll see you on the next video.